much for a herring.
Crown apiece.
Bacon, dog.
Wait, wolf's drop.
Need to chat.
I'm all ears, Witcher.
Tell me, how'd you meet the Ophiri you turned into a beast?
Aren't you a nosy one?
What's it matter? You like to talk about yourself.
That I cannot deny. Ophiri was a dofer on a voyage through lands unknown to learn of their cultures and customs. He fell for a lass. As it happened, this woman was already important to me. But at the time, I was now compared to a noble from a foreign land. So her parents promised her hand to the Ophiri, though she loved me. If you'd only seen his feeble attempts at charm. When she asked why he travelled disguised as a common merchant, he said he was like the frog from the fairy tale. One kiss from her, and he'd turn into a prince. Wanted to be a frog. Became a frog.
Got something for you.
I love gifts, but I prefer to unwrap them in private. Oi, lads, mind the barrels. Going out for a jabber with Geralt. Come. Oh, that's better. All right, what do you have for me?
Max Bersodi's house, as requested.
The papers, where are they?
Left them in the vault. You wanted the house, you got the house. Never mentioned its contents.
You're a quick study. Already as tricky as Odim himself. Keen to ridicule a man. Do you know what I and the company do with your type?
Dunno. Ask for legal advice? Looks to me like you might need some. You signed the contract, Olgierd. I'm just fulfilling its terms, to the letter. Unhappy? Hell, should have chosen your words more carefully.
Yes, I should have. I assume you came to an agreement with Horst. Shame. A right horse in that one.
His brother Ewald was worse.
Was?
Horst killed him with his own hands.
It's progress.
The Borsodis. What's your gripe? Get kicked out of an auction?
Worse. They evicted me from my home. Are you really interested?
All in all, not really. Just asking out of courtesy.
Commendable manners. Well, why do you stand there? Do you need something still?
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I must say to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yank the herring out the barrel.
Come on, none of this dallying.
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shites about what I've got to say?
I'm ready. I'm listening.
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality, and I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood? I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me, and don't spare your horse. Got it?
Aye, got it.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come with you. We must talk outside. Theophiri believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Must have made quite a few enemies along the way. Maybe not today and not tomorrow, but someday, someone will find a way to take you down.
And that should trouble me why. I feel no fear, no regret. The wise men of Oxenfurt claim there are no gods. After death, there is only the void. I've known this void already. Death holds no surprises.
Fulfilled two of your wishes. Time I learned the third.
Confident, aren't you? Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved.
In no mood for a heart-to-heart. I'm to do something for you. Tell me what it is.
A true professional, eh? Know what I think? I think you only feign the cold killer, when in fact you seek new and ever stronger sensations, as I do. Seek to prove to yourself that you are still able to feel, that some remnant of humanity remains within you. I'd make a right good witcher. Problem is, I don't know the road to Kaer Morhen, and I doubt you'd give me a pendant.
Cut the shit, Olgird. Third wish, still waiting to hear it.
Aye, aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one. Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you are. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this Dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you could tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor, east of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure. Goodbye, Geralt.
Fatherland. faster. Come on.
Let's go. Anyone there?
Move it.
Kendrick. Kendrick, you there?
Not so loud.
Ah! Oh, God, scared me off to...
Not so loud, I said. Fog's not natural. Could be something in there hiding. Foglets or air nymphs, for example. Don't want to attract them. Believe me.
Foglets? Oh, sweet mother Malitily, why did I ever come here?
Good question. What are you doing here?
See, Kendrick and me, we thought man has been empty all these years, full of fine things going to rot.
So you're a thief?
Thief steal from the living? What's the harm taking from the dead? Kendrick went to open the door. I stood watch. Suddenly heard his lamp smash. Then nothing. Quiet. Called out to him, but... What was that? One of them foglets you spoke of?
No.
Phew. That's a stone off my...
I'll see what that was and look for your partner. You...
Ain't about to wait around. I'm out of here.
Pretty sprawling, this estate. How am I gonna find that rose
still tending to the
flower beds? No violet rose, though. Fresh manure. Water's ice cold, mountain stream cold. Rather worn, used often. Wonder by who? A grave here? What are you doing in a place like this? Best shoe before you get hurt. Busted lamp, and the ground's trampled. Somebody dragged something this way. A body? Someone dragged a wounded man through here. From cleated boots, leading from the back of the garden. I'd scooch along, Kitty. This place. What's that? That digging? A lockpick? Must have been the other thieves. Graves, unmarked, laid out in rows, like garden beds.
Hey. Hear me?
Another thief. Body's mutilated.
Who are you?
Or nostrils, deformed organs. Damn thing had no right to be alive.
Well, philosophers do still debate what it means to be alive, exactly.
Normally I'd be shocked, but not after what I just saw. Who are you two?
Clearly not animals. Think of us as friends of the house.
What about this thing? What can you tell me? A friend of yours?
We called him the Caretaker.
Doesn't look like any creature I've ever seen. Where'd it come from?
From very far away. He was summoned to guard Lady Iris and the home. He tended the garden, took care of unwanted guests.
Very far away, meaning where exactly?
The name of this place would mean naught to you.
What's with the show? The pretense that you're animals. You couldn't have warned me?
No. We're obliged to maintain discretion.
So why talk to me at all?
Why? Well, we get so few chances to talk to humans, and we're curious to know what brought you.
Gonna need a better answer than that.
Later.
You know the master of the house, the owner?
Olgierd von Everick. Yes, we know him, but he left, and his wife became mistress of the house.
Great. So, Lady von Everick home? Could you announce me, say she has a guest?
Why do you wish to see her?
I'm here to get the violet rose Olgierd gave Iris just before he left.
Iris is inside, in the bedchamber upstairs. Take his key. It opens the rear door.
Guess I'll make my own introductions. So, how should I address you?
As you did now. We'd rather keep our names to ourselves.
gotta be careful. And everything's clean, ready for a meal to be served. Caretaker must still set the table. Families are all alike. Every unhappy family is unhappy in its own way. Fire damage. Interesting.
Thank you.
another intruder buried by the caretaker. Looks new. Bucket's been repaired. Gardener's hut. Could it be? Tools are so organized, it's scary. Families are all alike. Every unhappy family is unhappy in its own way.